Evening, how are you all this week? All right, fantastic. All right, brilliant. Welcome to the Mode 2 Records studio hangout with me. My name is James Hockley. I also go by the name of PIXELfreak and Frank Droid. You can check out the website mode2records.com. And if you want to get the parts for tonight's track, what we're going to be doing tonight is to write a track from scratch. I've got no idea what it is I'm going to be doing. So, if you want to get the parts for the track we write tonight, then sign up at mode2records.com. This is the seventh one I've done of these, so you can pop along to the YouTube channel, subscribe to the channel over there as well, which is what you're watching it on now. So brilliant. All right, so we'll crack on, but get yourselves over to mode2records.com if you haven't already. Get yourself signed up and we'll see you over there on the other side. You get loads of other free stuff and bits and pieces as well. Anyway, back to tonight's task. Let's write a track. So I'm going to flick you over to this for the screen because we're going to be able to see what we're doing there. Let me just pop you across here. Okay, there we go. So if you've watched before, you'll know that I write everything using the Akai MPC Renaissance, which is what I've got down here. And I'm going to start off with that, get some drums going, and then we'll get some other hardware, some of the keyboards I've got here behind me. We'll get them playing, and we'll see what we come up with. As I say, if you want the parts for that, I'll send them out on Friday, every Friday after the hangout. So if you want to get hold of them, get over to mode2records.com, get yourself signed up on the main list, and you'll get a copy of those parts as well, amongst other lots of lovely freebie stuff and bits and pieces. Anyway, let's crack on. So, gonna build a drum kit. I'm not going drums in here at the moment, so I'm going to just go into this folder here. I think we're gonna use Lin drum sounds tonight. Just use the kit drum, so I'm gonna load that into that one there. I'm going to go. Put the low snare drum in there. I'm going to get some hi-hats. There's some good old EastEnders sounding drums right there. So then we'll just go and find the open hat just there and load that one. And here I'll put the clap. Good old fashioned clap sound. Conga sounds on there as well. Guess you fancy some conga tonight. Symbol on the top there. We put this other snare drum just up in this top corner just in case I want to use it. Side stick. Shaker, we ain't got the tambourine there. The tambourine, so let's put the tambourine on as well. I always like to try and keep it within the drum machine if we can, and just get those toms. High tom, load. Okay, high tom, load. Mid tom, place. This is three toms, I only go four toms, I think. So put that on there. Two holes left. Let's see what else we can find in here. Might be interesting. Cabasa, that'll do in there. Just put a much slightly shorter hi-hat in there. What have we done there? Ah. There's that crash and warm. Move that into there. Yeah. And then just hit the wrong pads there. I said, well, there's a cowbell. Why not? Okay. There's our kit. Just save it very quickly. So it's just going to my folder, usual folder in here, and then my folder, and where's my PIXELfreak folder? There he is. New folder called Hangout 7. I can't believe we've done 7 of these Hangouts already. Pretty mental. Okay, so we'll just call this name here Hangout 7. Saved all those for me. And I'm just going to call this program here Lindrum. Now, these are the same samples that I was using last week from the same bank of samples I was using last week. Those, that folder, what's it called? The, where's the folder gone? A bit deeper samples, freebie samples were given away. I tweeted about it and put it up on Facebook and all that kind of stuff on the Mode2 Records Twitter and Facebook, which you can also follow me on. But make sure you do get over to YouTube and just subscribe to the channel as well. These are the samples I've used here. So this is the Lindrum samples from that same pack. I've just used on there, so I've not used these before. So I'm just going to go and call that program. Why didn't we name that program before? Because it's Lin, not Kindrum, Lindrum. Lindrum. Answers, please. Anybody knows what the Lindrum is and why it's such a famous machine? If you like, that'd be fantastic. Get some feedback in the comments section below this video. If you don't know what Lindrum is, then find out what it is, because it's a pretty famous machine. Okay, so got that Lindrum sample there. Let me just go and save the patch out as well. I'm going to go and save that. Actually, no, we won't worry about saving that for a moment. I'll just resave that. I'll save that later on. Okay, so we could probably do a straight on 4 on the floor. I'm going to make it a bit different tempo this time. So we're going to speed up just a slight little bit. Maybe take it to 124. Let's try it. Let's see what we get. So I'm going to put it into record and we'll just put a little pattern in and see how we get on. Straightforward. 4 on the floor. Move that window for you so you can see what's going on here. Okay, so knock it out of overdub. Okay. Okay, let's just put some hats in. So raise those front ones. Program there without that repeat on. Undo that.
Let's just do that again there. Actually, what I might do actually is to just bring that whole line back and then fill the end in. That ran a little bit as well. A bit more editing this week on here, I think. Knock those out of there. All I'm going to do is back this back across over here and then grab these two and pull them there. And that's not grooving for me, so I'm just going to delete them all and start again. So let's just go and erase that. Okay, let's just do a straightforward. Let's just do this hi-hat again here. No. Right, let's get rid of these snare drums. I'm just using the delete key on the keyboard, no normal Mac keyboard here. Okay. That's better. It's a better snare drum, I think. So what I've done there is I've just used pad mute mode on the MPC just to mute that sound out. Big snare. Okay, let's see some of that in there. Thank you. try that on there. Save that for a moment. Now I'm just going to go and lengthen the sequence with normally. I would just work on a 2-bar loop, but this time I think we're going to work on slightly longer. We're going to maybe work on an 8-bar loop, just to make it a bit different. Because I've done that on one of these hangouts before. So let's just go and do that. So I'm going to go into edit sequence, as you can see here on my LCD display I've got on the screen here for you. I'm just going to do copy bars, and then we're going to merge it. Let's do merge, and I'm just going to do it again. Merge. It'll give us 8 bars. You can see on the screen now we've got an 8-bar pattern here. Let's go and give it a bit of a mix on the program. So I'm going to go program mix mode, which gives me all the faders for the drums. You can see on the screen here, I've got all the each pad. I can put an insert on each one of these. So let's go add an insert into here. We're going to add, I think, a little reverb on this little fella here. Just a little one, small reverb on that. And let's edit that. So when I do editing, and the reason why I like using the MPC when writing is that you guys see that MPC down there? I don't know if you can. Let's move it down like that. There we go. That's better, isn't it? You can see it now. So when I use MPC, it's great because whatever I'm doing on here, it echoes it on these Q-link controls over this side. So I'm now controlling by moving actual physical knobs on here as opposed to fiddling on the mouse on the screen. So I can actually change the mix, the decay. I'll just switch off that CZ because it's a bit noisy. So I can take low cut. So I have that on there, to close that window off. And I've got four, I don't know if you can see here on four little squares under here. I've got four little inserts I can put on each individual pad, which is pretty cool. I'm just sticking a compressor on here as well. Just a VCA compressor, because I like VCA compressors. We're gonna edit that. Change, bring the threshold down a little bit. And the ratio. Not too much. More punch on it. That's off. On there as well. It's great. You actually do it by listening to it rather than watching what's on the screen. On, off, on. Brilliant. Okay. So close that window. And then we're going to do a straightforward mix of it. We're going to levels. I'm just going to play it. I can actually bring down. MPC 3000 mode as well, because it gives a bit more extra grit. And change the panning on it, which you're not going to really hear too much on there at the moment. So let's just go to inserts for 6. I'll put a delay on it here because I'm going to use a delay on it. Put a reverb on it again. So I'll put a delay on it when I'm putting Pro Tool to mix it. Let's find the reverb again here. Let's put a little EQ on it. Let's put a more brightness on there. Okay, second insert. I'm going to find reverb. Already. Let's edit that. Is there a gated reverb? I'm assuming there's a bit of gated reverb on here. Let's try and get some of that on there. At all. Maybe it is in gate then. Sounds pretty good anyway. Okay. Let's go back to levels and just mix that a bit more there. Let's responded a bit there. Using the command key. Another new feature of the latest version of PC software. So that sounds all right to me. Got a good old groove going on there. One thing I'm going to quickly do with it is I'm just going to go back to the main mode here on the screen. Got time correct. I'm going to do it on 32nd notes, so we're going to do it on 16th notes. Time correct it to a swing, 52. Now, no, correct all events, 52, okay. Nice little swing going there. Do some keyboardy stuff now. Let's just switch on to this camera. Here we go. Okay. Thank you. idea.
Read that bit. Okay, so maybe what we'll do is we're using this JX3 here, and the MIDI on it, it's got MIDI on it, but it's a bit of a weird MIDI because it won't let you program it and play it on MIDI at the same time because it's of that age. There's a great keyboard and has an amazing sound. So what I'm going to do is, like I've done in the past couple of weeks, is just record it into the MPC. And let it come in. We should come in. There he is, right. So bring the volume up a bit on here. JX up. Select auxiliary SF100, okay. Don't give it too much away, it's my vocal compressor. So, because I've got this running through all these keyboards, basically running through this mixer here, if you go over to the mode2records site and you sign up, one of the freebie things you'll get is I've done like a studio tour. If you're a bit of a geek for studios, I'll do like a studio tour of what I've got in here, explains it a bit more. But I've basically got a little mixer in here, which feeds out through this little processor and then the compressor. And it's got some effects from the MPX 100. Let's call MPX 100 there as well. That then feeds in stereo into my Roland MX1 mixer, which is then linked by its auxiliary output into the inputs of the MPC, so that the MPC can sample anything. Now I'm going to flick you back to the other screen. This screen here. There we go. So flick back to here. And what hopefully you're going to be able to see, now I'm on here, is when I go to record, so sample record on here, we should be getting sounds coming in there. Thank you.
I'm going to start off each one of those chords, basically in one long thing. I'm not going to play it into time or anything. I'm just going to play the chords and let it ring out. Play the next chord and let it ring out. So I'm just going to go into record on the MPC now. And we're going to go. Stop. Okay, so there we have on the screen now. Now the sounds. Grab your seat. Now we're going to give it a name for the sample. We're going to call it JX Pad. No program. Fine. Keep. Now I'm going to go into sample edit mode. Just shut that off there because it gets a bit noisy from the mixer. Okay, so I'm going to use the cue links again just to edit it in. So I have a bring it right in on the nose of the sounds here like that, and then take the end point just like you would do in any sampler really, end point up to about there. Let's just zoom in on that start point again. Yeah, I thought I just messed that up. I'm just taking the samples. Okay, so now I'll process that and I'm going to extract it using the extract function. Do it. It creates you one sample. And I'm going to bring the end point across here. And pull that across to get the right on the button at the start of this one. There we go. Bring the endpoint in a bit, I don't need to be that long for this one. Process, extract, endpoint again, cross over here, and start point again over here as it auto saves the project for me. Let's wind this over to here. Okay, get that. Okay, process, extract, and then we skip this last one, next one there, go to here, bring this all the way across to here, move it across into here. Okay. Extract that one, and then go back to program edit. I'm going to make this track back into a drum track. I'm going to create a new drum program, and then all of my new samples will be up in the all samples list here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we go, I'm going to drag 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. So we've got all on there. Now it's all going to overlap like that unless I change it. So I'll normally change it all to monotone. Like that, and go back here. And give it a bit of amp release. Give an 80 amp release on there as well. They all got 80 amp release on there. So we can do little stutters like that with it. Or we can just play it in like we were playing before. With our kit playing. Okay, let's just undo that. Let's get a play something on here. Sound. Try it on the BX there. Let's flick you over to the other camera so you can see what's going on. Into that camera there. Okay, so. Thank you. Bad. Let's just give it another go using using the JPO8 or maybe the JUO6. Let's try that. So let's go and make this into a, let's give it a MIDI track. MIDI. And C. Should give us JPO8. Okay, so let's call up. That lovely bass sound from the JPO8. All right. the I think the micro boots a better sound, which is actually the same sound we had last week, because it's I haven't actually changed it since last week's session. So let's just pop that in. Put that in over the track. So let's just do that for a moment. Notes change would help, wouldn't it, really? Let's just try it again. Sounds pretty terrible. Let's try, let's go back to C again. I'm just going to drop the tempo down a bit to make it a little bit easier to play those notes on it. Thank you. PC, then just record that in as audio. So I'm looking at getting the sound from the JPO8, which is on USB 3 channel here, sending out to, let me put you back on the other screen, hold on a second, there we are. Ah, but you see me now, there you go, right, fantastic. So yeah, I'm just gonna go and record that in again now. Okay, let's just pop that in sample record. Make sure we've got, there we go, we've got the JPO8 coming in. 50 second recording time. So we're gonna press record and then press play on the sequencer to trigger the JPO8 to play and record it in. Here we go. Go right. So we're going to keep that. We're going to not call it JXPad 5. We're going to call it JP Bass. JP Bass. I'm going to keep that. Now we're going to go to edit mode and just pull that, trim it in. We're going to have it play it as one sample. We're not going to fiddle about changing it, making it into individual sounds and reprogramming it. I'll keep it as the, as just as the sequences and play it off in one note. let's undo that. I can't undo it. Okay, fine. I can undo it. I've undone it there. All right. Process. And we want to do this time discard it. Here we go. Okay, so we're going to go main mode. Track 3 has got the MIDI on it, so we're going to mute track 3. Go to track 4 and create a new program. New, make it a drum program again, so I'll just trigger it off with a single pad. And we're going to, this time we're going to program edit. Samples. I'm going to put JP bass, not on that note. Oh, this one. And again, I'm going to make it so that it's note on with a bit of release. Just in case you want to do anything else with it. Do the main, save that. Let's rename this as JX Pad. We'll rename this as JP8 Bass. P8 Bass. Okay. Let's just drop that in. Sounds pretty cool at that speed. Let's get a little arpeggio going, shall we? Let's can I trigger an arpeggio on? Let's get it running on one of these keyboards. Let's get the D5 maybe. Let's get this. Might be quite nice. So let's just call up Clockworks here, which is the oh, it's already wired. This is the management software for my MIDI interface. I've got it in my rack over here. This allows me to route basically any input to any output or mix. Any input to any output. So I can actually record. So that's playing. What is that playing? Is it playing the? No, it's not playing that. It must be playing that. D5. 3. Oh, I'm on my stumble mode this way. Okay. So let's go to part 3. It's part 1 on then. Part 1 is on A38. Let's go to part 3. A38. Okay. So now, my Big Step Pro here, I'll have to get out of the camera and just so I can bring it in over the top here, I think. I can now sort of play around and make a little sequence on here. Drum track off there. Let's get this synced up. Let's get the MPD to send some signal. Mate, it'll already be synced, sending it out actually. No, it's not sending it. Okay, let's get it to send sync signals to the. Oh, it should be sending it. Step Pro. Okay. There we go. So if I drop my Beat Step Pro into record here, I can actually play the notes. Sounds. Oh, excuse me. Thank you. join them. So I've got a drum sequencer set up here as well. It also plays the drum sounds from the D5. It's got a bit of delay on it. Sounds. Actually, you know what I might do? So actually give it a second. Yeah, why does it do that? Okay, let's just keep that. Save sequencer to pattern three and save it to pattern four. Pattern four four's got that and that in it. Okay, so that's pattern four. So pattern three. Okay, that's what we're going to do. We're going to record that in like that. Just flicking between the two sequences. So I'll get a bit more variation on there. Which would be cool. So let's just go and sample that. So sample record mode again, make sure we're getting sound in from there. That's great. So let me go record. Discard that, let's just try that again. I want to make sure we're on, we stop on the right note. Okay, right. Perfect. Stop. Okay. So we're going to call this D5 sequence. Okay, I'm going to give it no program, keep, and edit. And again, we're coming in here. On, brilliant. Okay. Okay. Process that and discard it, and then we're going to save that starters there, back to here. And we've got the bass on there, so we're going to do another new program, drum program. Rename it as D5 sequence. And then I'm just going to go to program edit, samples. Call in the sample we want, wherever it is. Is he gone? All right, I'll drag him in then. Just drag it in. Samples. Called that then. JP Base 2 for some reason. Okay. All right. Let's go back and rename that. JP Base 2. Rename that to D5 sequence. Here we go. And again with the sample, no tone. A bit of tail end on it as well. There we go, main. Okay, let's just undo that and do that again. Okay. As well, and I think we'll call that enough writing. We've got half an hour to do a bit of work on exporting it out. Maybe we shouldn't do that tonight. Maybe we should just leave it tonight, and maybe we should just because I do the same thing every week. I always put it into Pro Tools and then just put some effects and stuff on it, so you guys have seen me do that. So maybe we shouldn't do that this week. Maybe we should just leave, stay in here and keep playing in here for another half an hour and see what we come up with then. Let's try that through this week. Let's push the boat out a bit. All right, so let's get this drum part. Let's put the snare drum in first. So I'm going to put in. Thinking about this. We need one of those snares, don't we? I can just play it back in on here. What is this? What's the whole pattern do on here? Let's just do. Thank you. Yeah. I was wondering what to do about, whether to put that into here or whether just to stick that straight into Pro Tools when we get it into Pro Tools. No, let's stick it in here. Let's stick it in here. I'm going to mute that one. Okay, here we go. Okay, let's do sample edit on that. Probably called that JP bass now by not naming it. So we're going to use this as a loop, as opposed to playing the sounds in. Process that, just discard all that. Okay, and then we go to main. Actually, I'm going to put it in the same D5 sequence program. Let's just drag it in. Let's rename it first. So D5 claps. I type in the 5 as well, James, that would help, wouldn't it? D5 claps, okay. And then we're going to chuck that on another pad on the same. We'll put it on a different track. So if we've got. I can use the same program on different tracks. So I've got track 6 here. I'm just going to the same D5 sequence program. Put it on here. Okay. Triggered the sample at the end here, so that it gives it a slightly different pattern, so that that's gives it a, yeah, just give it a different type of pattern towards the end of the sequence there. Cool. Do we want to put this snare drum in as well? Let's unmute that. We'll just re-trigger it. There we go. Right. So let's name this D5 snare. And we're gonna put it onto, we're gonna put it on pad 3. Keep, edit. pull this across here. And in there like that. Okay, discard that. Okay, main, already on the track. So we just need to go track up. Shuffle the drums so the snare drums in time and more. Might just try doing is just taking out every other one just to see what it sounds like with it on every other snare rather than every snare. Okay, so let's just go and pop an effect on that. So we program edit. And then we want to go program mix, then we sorry, program mix. And we're gonna go on that pad there, insert, and this time I'm gonna go and get, let's just save this. I'm gonna go and get RC24, because I've got that loaded in here as well. Now this obviously is slightly different. Using this on the screen here, you can see that we haven't got everything. Actually, probably have got everything on there. Pre-delay, depth, intensity, modulation, bass, mid, crossover, high cut, we have got everything on there. I'm going to go and choose the mix control on there. So I'm going to just put on a large, let's try an air on it. Let's try that, shall we? Solo. From here, okay. So mix is this one. Depth. So you can change it. Oh wow, that's amazing. That's pretty clever. Okay. but I'm going to just go and change it for the RC48, which is the Big Brother version of it. This is the like the 480L version of it. Oh, and it's crashed it. Brilliant. Oh, it's crashed it. It's the first time I've actually used that plugin in MPC, especially MPC 9. Whatever it was that updated last week. Let's just go and find the session. And there, Hangout 7. There he is, 2341. So a couple of minutes ago it was saved. That's good. Loading that for me. Yes, it's done. Ah, just reboot the MPC hardware. And now we've got to redo the audio drivers very quickly. And check it back. There we go. Okay, so let's go back up to my drum track again here. There we go. All right, I'm going to do a program mix. Insert onto there. Now, do we try putting the RC48 on it again? Let's try it. It's opening the window. We crashed it last time. Okay, let's close that and come back out here, and just so we can hear with the track solo what it's going to sound like. Up the window again. Okay, switch it to mix mode, mix. Okay. See what it does if we change it to something larger. Okay, let's take that mix up a bit. Yeah, it's too much delay on it. Not quite right. Let's see what that sounds like in the truck. Thank you. that's pretty cool. Save that. Close that window. Okay, so now we've got a track mixer here, and what I'm going to do on this is do a bit of a little basic mixing just on the track mixer. I don't know what we've got plugging the track in there for. The plugin program, we don't have a plugins in here. Let me just go back and look at that so we get rid of that there. Plugin 01, let's delete that. Yeah, there's nothing in it. MIDI 01. It's probably being used by the baseline track. Okay. So I'm going to explode the tracks on the drum kit. Explode that, which has now exploded it. So when I go back into track mix mode again, now you see I've got masses more tracks, kicks, snare, all that kind of stuff on here. So this is now muted because that's the kit. I'm going to go and name that now. Go back to main. So track one is Lindrum. People figured out what the Lindrum is if you haven't didn't already know. Answers below this video if you like. So we're going to go track up. That's going to be JX pad. Track up again. JP8 MIDI. Track up again. JP bass. Okay, track up. And we've got D5 sequence. Track up again, and we've got D5 claps, and again, that one there, track up again, and we've got D5 snare, and then here we've got kick. It's not hertz. Collapse. Cabasa. Snare. Conga. High conga. And that's it. Okay, so that's all the tracks we've got. So when I go to track mix on here, I should have all of my tracks on here. Let's see if I can tell it to not show programs. Return to the mixes, show unused programs. Show programs. Okay, so now I've got just my tracks here. I used to be able to put plugins on the tracks, but you can't do that anymore. So we're just going to do a basic track mix here. Let's do programs. We could have won that. So we'll do tracks on here. Tracks. Open up my LCD window again. You get to see what I'm doing. So here we've got tracks. Everything's at 127, so I'll knock it all down. Okay, everything's at 127. We should get a basic mix going, and then that will be the end of tonight's session. Don't forget, of course, sign up to mode2records.com. Get yourselves over to mode2records.com. Sign yourselves up on the mailing list that pops up as the first window, and you'll get the parts for this track. You'll get the parts for all the other tracks I've done in the last 6 Hangouts. You'll get free mixes. You'll get free tracks. You'll get exclusive mixes, DJ mixes, all that kind of stuff. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel you're watching this on now.
If you do that, it'd be amazing. And don't forget to check out the video. It's what the tracks have released. In the new one this week, Super JX was the track released this week. It's going okay. It's going all right, you know. Not too bad. All right, so let's just do a quick mix on here. So we're going to press play. We're going to bring the kick drum up. No, we're not. We're going to bring the JX pad up. Is that right? We got lost audio again here. Let's go and rejiggle that system preference again here. Let's go and do that. So we've lost audio again here. Okay, so let's just do that and that again. There we go. Right, okay. Let's start off with the drums. We'll do on the outputs here, we'll do a very quick little just compression stuff on here. I've got all the VSTs lined up on here, so I can just put on something like the glue. Actually, I'm not going to put the glue on it at all. We're going to go into the internal effects. I'm just going to put on a compressor master on there. So let's just go. Just giving it a bit more of a mix before we take it to Pro Tools. So that'll do for this evening, I think. As I say, let's put you back here. So as I say, thanks for watching. It's been a pleasure having you here in the studio. I hope it's been useful. I hope it's been good. I hope you've been giving you a bit of an insight into what happens when I'm writing tracks. And yeah, nice. There'll be another one next week. It might be on Wednesday next week, but I'll let you all know about that on the mailing list, which you can get to by signing up to mode2records.com. As I said, exclusive mixes, exclusive music just for you if you sign up for that mailing list. Subscribe to the YouTube channel. Follow us on Twitter. Follow us on Facebook. All the usual stuff and bits and pieces. Let's do all that kind of stuff. The more people I get signed up, the more free stuff I can give away. and the more of this sort of thing we can do, which would be awesome. So thanks again for watching. Sign yourselves up at mode2records.com. If you have already, get your mates and all your family and friends and everybody to come and sign up and join up and watch what we do. Fantastic. See you next week. Thanks. Bye.